Hi, for Janelle?
Yes.
How are you doing?
I'm so glad to see you. Excuse me. You drive a Lyft too, or just Uber?
No, just Uber.
Lyft, I don't know what's going on, but I've been standing there for an hour waiting on the Lyft. Some said try Uber.
Oh, yeah, there must be no drivers, you know.
Oh, my area. God.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. I'm like, I need to get home.
Yeah, most of the drivers, they drive in the downtown area on weekends.
Oh, my goodness. And just, the app just keeps saying, okay, book your ride later. Try in a few minutes.
Yeah.
Try in a few minutes. Try. Some
say, how long did you wait for Lyft?
An hour?
Oh my God.
Yeah. And so, told me
no driver connected?
Nobody connected. Just keep throwing me at the app.
Oh, shit.
You know, I'm like, you know what? Screw it. I stood there and downloaded the Uber app. I'm like, I got to get home.
Yeah.
You know.
There must be no drivers in this area.
And you was 3 minutes. I'm like, what the mess?
I actually moving towards the downtown.
Huh?
And I live in Highland, so
okay.
I turn on my app while I'm going towards the downtown.
Okay, so that was good because I'm going west.
Yeah.
You'd be almost downtown when you drove me out.
Yeah.
We passing downtown, but still.
Yeah.
You know, oh my goodness. I was like, oh my God. I'm gonna ever get home.
So you work here?
Yes, I work here. Yeah.
So you come all the way from this?
Yep, and I take a lift every day.
Every day?
Yeah,
it's too expensive.
Yep, there and back.
And probably $50 every day.
$50 a day. Mm-hmm. Until COVID is over, you know, get a little bit of hand on COVID.
Yeah.
And, I've been doing this since March.
Oh my God.
Yeah. At first, taking the ride was so easy because there was no traffic, no nothing.
Yeah,
everybody's
yeah.
back out. But I'm just, you know, the buses, I'm not supposed to have so many people on it.
Yeah.
I got on there one day, I was like, nope, can't do it. I was just saying, I got a bus card. I ain't never been using my wallet.
I heard like when Corona was at its peak, they were not charging you the bus fare.
Yeah.
Was it?
But since they started back charging the fare, there's less buses out here now. Now, when they wasn't charging fare, they had a lot of buses.
Okay.
I took it maybe on a few times, but I wasn't going that far from home.
Okay.
You know, and the bus would be empty, and I'd try it, you know. I took my grandkids on it, and then one day I got on there, it was crowded. Then a few times, I just seen, like, buses being crowded, trains crowded.
Yeah.
Nobody is watching the people, you know, saying there's too many people on here.
No social distancing.
Yeah, and everybody's trying to get home, so ain't nobody gonna wait for another train.
Yeah.
I have, you know, when they first, I'm not getting on no crowded train.
Yeah.
I'm scared, you know, you're supposed to see it's a seating pattern on there.
Yeah.
Nobody's following the seating pattern. I'm not being, you know, funny or anything, but I don't want nobody sitting next to me.
Yeah.
I just don't. You know, even though I have my mask on and stuff, I just don't want to be that close to anybody.
Yeah, right.
You know, I'm trying to stay COVID free.
Yeah.
You know, my son had it, and he was really sick, you know.
Oh, your son had a corona?
Yeah, and he was very sick.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I didn't see him for like 3 weeks, about a month. I didn't get to see him, you know, because I have underlying health issues, so I had to be sure. You know, and it was so, you know, it's so easy to get it. You know, he was at a family member house that had it. And then the family member sent out a text to all the family because they had like a little baby shower. You know, just immediate family was there, whatever. You know, I didn't go. But next,
did he quarantine for 14 days?
Yeah, he was in quarantine more than 14 days.
Okay.
He was really sick.
Okay.
You know. And
he's okay now?
Yeah, he's much better now. He lost a lot of weight.
Okay.
You know, he's trying to get his health, you know, his strength back. But yeah, that was in April that he caught it, you know. But,
so what was happening when he got corona? Like, was he coughing or fever or?
Yeah, you know what? He thought maybe he was trying to come down with the flu, but
mm-hmm.
Before the family member found out,
mm-hmm.
he disappeared. He's like, I hope I ain't got the virus. So he went to the hospital to get, you know, let them know. They said he didn't have it. They sent him back home. They didn't even see him. They just said, you don't have it, you know, you don't have this common cold. But he had made an appointment to go get tested at one of the local CVS's or something. And he was getting sicker, but by the time he had his appointment, he went and said, still go get tested. He just thought he was sick because they told me he didn't have it. But when he got tested, like a day later, they called and said he had it and to stay quarantined. But he had already went into quarantine before they told him because he was sick. So the kids and stuff wasn't around him because they had been at my house, you know, because of Corona, and school was out, and they were at home with me.
And how old is your son?
He's 37.
37.
So after he found out that none of the kids can go back home, but my older two grandkids had to be tested because they was with him at the baby shower.
Oh, okay.
So thank God they didn't have it, everybody, the family members did come up with it. So, I felt bad because the cousin baby shower, well, their newborn baby had it.
Oh my God, newborn baby had it?
The newborn baby, the mother and the father had it, but they had another child at home that was 3 years old. He didn't even get it.
Okay.
So they had to remove him from the home while they go in quarantine. Yeah, but the newborn baby had it. They didn't know.
Did anything happen to newborn baby? Like, is it affected?
He's healthy.
Oh, he does.
But they don't know if the mother, when she gave birth, did she have the baby had corona?
Okay.
They didn't test them. You know, she gave birth or anything, but yeah, all of them had it. And then, but out of all the people that had it, my son was the sickest. It was like, you know, I was scared. We didn't hear from him. He was so sick, he didn't answer the phone. You know, then nobody go, you know, his dad would go over there, you know, every now and then check on him, and he didn't get an answer. So then I started sending him text messages. I'm like, if you don't answer, I'm gonna kick your door in. And I'm gonna have the police with me because I don't know if he did or not in my house. And he still didn't answer. And that following day he asked me, like, Mom, I'm just too sick. Can I call you back? I said, no, you're gonna listen. I said, I need you to get up. It's been over 14 days. I need you to get up, take a shower, remove all that bed and off your bed because you're laying in germs. And I prayed over him. Day later, he just started getting much better. Was like, he didn't have the strength. And then we had a sanitation team come in and sanitize his whole house. So when my grandkids come back home, I don't have to be worried, but I bought Lysol, wipes, you know, ordered all that stuff, you know, offline. And then stuff that we had at the office, I took, you know, home, made sure he had it. And so now I keep everything in his car. We have him to use for my grandkids. You know, I buy them so many masks.
Okay.
You know, they didn't know their dad had corona. And so kids just say whatever they say. Yeah. You know, they're like, don't do that. I might get coronavirus. You know, I'm like, no. They, you know, so they are so paranoid with it because everybody's talking about it. Uh-huh. And they see stuff on the news and they don't want to die. So they just keep wearing masks. You know, I don't have to make them wear masks. They wear their masks. And they do, you know, they 5 and 6 years old, and 9 year old. The bigger kids keep theirs.
Yeah.
You know, my son raising his kids on his own. And my grandson called me, he's 13, and grandma had never been away from my dad this morning, is he gonna be okay? I'm like, yeah. And then it made me get worried because they said he was talking to the kids, like he gonna never see them again, and he was gonna die, you know. We had to take him back to the hospital because he wasn't getting better. And so his dad took him to Amherst, and I said, I need to stay on the speaker the whole time you're there so I can see what's going on. And because my niece passed away during COVID. She was only 28.
Oh, she passed away?
Yeah.
Due to coronavirus?
Uh-huh. And the thing with her is, she went to the hospital. They sent her back home.
Oh.
Said the same thing. She didn't have coronavirus. It was a cold. Her asthma maybe been flared up due to her allergy. She was at home for 2 hours, called an ambulance again, sent her back to the hospital. She was there 15 minutes. They gave her morphine. And then maybe 10 minutes after they gave her morphine, they was putting her on a ventilator. And 10 minutes after the ventilator, she went into cardiac arrest and died. And if you're COVID and you're on a ventilator and you cardiac, they don't resuscitate you. So people can still probably live if they resuscitate them, but they don't. So when my son went to Amherst, and they said his oxygen level was too high. I never heard of too high, I've heard of low. So yeah. I was like, well, what's that mean? You know, you're not putting them on a ventilator or anything. The lady said, no, we don't use a ventilator here. Okay. They had learned that when you put somebody on a ventilator, you shock the body with COVID. And that's why a lot of people doesn't make it back. And so she's like, we're going to give him an asthma pump, some antibiotics and stuff like that. And he's just going to have to just wait it out, Mom. I was like, okay, you know. So I told his dad, go get all his prescriptions filled. And, you know, I told my son, you use the inhaler when you can't, you know, you feel like you can't breathe. Oh. You know. And so I was telling my son, because he really pretty much is have good health, you know. But I told him, I think, because last year, around this time, he caught pneumonia. So he has never been sick with colds and stuff like that. So I tell him, I don't think your body was too fighting with that pneumonia, because he had pneumonia pretty bad. And so that's why we thought maybe it was the pneumonia came back, but it was COVID, because he had pneumonia last year. And he was really, really bad with that pneumonia too. And so I said, what is wrong with you? You're the picture of health. Man, these last 2 years, you just scared the mess out of me. First pneumonia, not corona. You know, but I had two family members pass away.
Two family members passed away, of course.
Yeah, my cousin was the first ones who passed away. He was 51 years old. He had underlying health issues. Uh-huh. And then my niece, she was 28, you know. And I feel so bad because she got her son here, and she's a twin. So you see the sister. The other twin, he always said, Mommy coming back. He always asked his mama coming back. So, you know, so everybody helped take care of him. You know, he's only three.
Okay.
Yeah. So, he said,
may God protect everyone in your family.
Yeah, you know, it's Corona had really put my family through a scare.
The people who got Corona, before they got Corona, they were like, was he serious about it? Did he believe that the corona exists?
Yeah, and you know.
Or he was like not careful?
You know what, and I think that was my son, he knew it existed, but he didn't think he'd be one of the ones to get it.
Okay.
Because I always be on him about, wear your mask here, son. Nah. I said, you don't want to put one on my grandkids.
Yeah.
You know, I said, this stuff ain't playing. And then when he called, he was like, Mom, please don't say I told you so. I said, I'm not telling you I told you so. I said, because you already know so, because you got it. I said, but this stuff, it's serious, and it's real, you know. And I wasn't gonna get tested. You know, I just didn't wanna go through the test. I'm like, I don't wanna go to the test, and I don't want them putting any in my body and nothing like that. You know, I know it's real, you know, but they said that all the employees had to be tested, you know. And so I had to get tested, but thank God we all came back negative, you know.
Yeah.
It was a weight lifted off my shoulder, you know, that I wasn't. I tried to really, you know, people say, you COVID, you have COVID phobia. I sure do. You know.
You know it's real.
Yeah.
A lot of people, they don't believe that.
I can tell you this. Back in, February? Went to California, and the week before I went to California, I was in a lift, and a young man, we was talking about him doing a share ride with another young man. So we was talking about it, and the young man who was driving said, it's going to get real bad, we're going to be stuck in our houses, it's going to be hard to get food, and this, that, and the other. I said, look, it ain't getting that serious now, come on, it's just a virus, you know. We've been through many viruses before.
He was
like, no, it's going to get bad. It's going to really get bad. I said, well, I hope it waits till I get out back from my trip.
Because
my grandson plays for a traveling basketball team, and we was going to California.
Okay.
So when we got on the plane, my son said, my other son said, y'all got on the mask? I said, boy, anybody wearing no mask on no plane? it ain't that serious. He said, don't come back to my house when y'all come, telling his son, you go live with your grandma, that she asked you, gonna get, y'all gonna get coronavirus out there with no mask on. So we was just laughing at him. And this is when Kobe had died. And the day we came back from California, the day that Kobe's funeral was, they gave him at the Staples Center. And my grandson wanted to go. I'm like, we ain't gonna be able to go because we have to have a ticket and, you know, we got to catch a plane back and all that. Yeah. So when we got back, the following week is when it really started getting serious. They had their first case of coronavirus in California.
Okay.
I'm like, oh, Lord, I hope we gonna be all right. We just came from California, too. My son said, I told y'all to wear a mask. Now, if something happened to my child, I'm getting you, Mama, because I told you to put a mask on my son.
Yeah.
I said, boy, it ain't all that. So a few weeks later, it started. That's when they shut the school down. But the couple of days before they shut the school down, me and my brother got a phone call from Homeland Security. We have family members that worked there. They said for us to go to the store and start buying stuff for our house. Because it was about to start shutting everything down. And sure enough, maybe he thought it was going to be that Monday or Tuesday. It maybe been like that Thursday, Friday, started sending it out saying, going to start shutting it down, phase one, and shut every school, stores, and you know, and I'm like, okay, so before everybody could get all the tissue and paper towel, we had stocked up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because we had kind of got wind what was going to happen, you know.
Yeah.
But believe me, when we was stocking up our stuff, it was not really in these stores, you know.
Yeah.
And I took a week off from work just to get my mind right and, you know, and see that I'm gonna still go to work, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but, you know, I did. And
so what do you think about that? Is like a lot of people think that there will be a second wave of coronavirus in winters.
You know what? I believe there will be a second wave. Even though, you know, it's supposed to, the cold is supposed to help you with the virus, but I really believe that is because you gotta look at now, you got Florida, you got Texas, and you got, is it California?
Yeah.
Okay.
New York.
Okay, yeah, New York, Texas, and is it California? Because it's not Florida anymore. I think it's California that are the main three hot spots. But you got to remember, everybody go vacation to all these places.
Yeah.
And they coming back home and they bringing the germs home with them. Now, the only people who be safe for a little while are the people who had corona already and with the antibodies and you know in their bodies now. Mm-hmm. So they are pretty much the only ones who are really safe right now.
Yeah.
But if the riots started back in Illinois, I'm going to just stay home.
I'm
going to go to work. Because I just can't, I can't get sick.
Yeah.
Because there's nobody to take care of me. You know, my son, you know, but I don't want my son to have to take care of me. I want them to take care of their children.
Yeah.
You know, I know my grandkids would come in a heartbeat, the older ones, to take care of me. But I don't want them to take care of me because I don't want them to have to get sick behind me. So I'm trying to, you know, I would do the best for me, you know.
Yeah.
Thank God for you drivers out here.
Yeah.
I really thought you guys was not gonna be, you know, working. When they had said that the unemployment would be for you guys too, you guys would get the stimulus money as well. But, you know,
yeah, I was working the whole, you know, corona thing between all.
I know all a lot of people drive for live.
Yeah. But I was very careful. I was wearing masks, wearing gloves, keep the windows down.
Yeah.
I have a disinfectant. I still have a disinfectant spray in my car.
Mm-hmm.
I have a hand sanitizer. So I was taking all the safety precautions because my wife was pregnant when this was all happened. She gave a birth to my son on the September.
10th of September?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, it's my son's birthday. That's me. My 37-year-old. He made 37 September 10th. Yeah. Good day, good day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good child, you know, that's why, you know, he's not perfect, but he's a good dad. He's raising all his kids, but five of them, they live with him. So single dad, you know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
In California?
No, he's here. No, we just traveled to California for a basketball game.
Okay.
Yeah, but...
So you just have one son?
No, I have two.
Two?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. They both live in Illinois?
Yeah, one is 30 and one 37.
Okay.
Yeah.
Doesn't live with you?
No, unfortunately.
Okay.
He lives one place, I live another place, but we're good friends now, so.
Okay.
It's better that we live apart.
Alright.
Yeah. Yeah, anyway.
Alright.
Yeah, but yeah. I don't know if he had corona or not, because he got sick, but he didn't go to the hospital.
Okay.
He just stay home and quarantine. I'm like,
okay. My man said the phone go.
Go ahead, go ahead.
All right.
Oh, feel like that. You may need to just get one chain to this scene. The chain could probably go.
Thank you.
bad self. This is it right here.
So. All right.
Yeah, and
have a good one.
I didn't have to order them. All right, you have a good day. Good
Thank weekend. You. Thank you.
Stay safe.
Thank you, too. have a child. How you doing, man? Mm-hmm. Good, good. here? All right, man. Have a good one. Hi, for Zakia. How you doing?
Good, man.
Good, thank you.
It's right here. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a good one.
You too.
Thank you. Thank you. For Jamila?
Yes.
How are you?
Good.
Good, thank you.
Head to your drop off at 1218 as Kent Vale Avenue.
Thank you. here?
Yeah.
Have a good one.
Head to your pickup at 3723 Knott's Flournoy Street.
for Brianna?
Yeah.
How you doing, man? Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, man. Have a good one. Thank you. Half a mole. How you doing? right here. Have a good one.
Thank you.
Thank you.
pod. Yeah, it's here.
What address you are located at? Hold on. 701? Can you give me, text me the address? Yeah, it's 630-400-0839. Yeah, 630-400-0839. And text, yeah, text me with your name. So I'll and the address, I'll drop it off and I'll report over. Yeah. Yo. Hi, for Ravi?
Yeah, dude.
How you doing, man?
Good, how are you, dude?
Good, thank you. Still going on?
I don't know.
Okay.
You never know with the weekend. But
yeah.
I don't think so.
Yeah. I was driving south and someone going from south to west. Yeah. Now I'm going downtown. Just recording. If you know, like, anything happens and inside the car, I'll just turn it.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah. You know, sometimes you get crazy passengers too.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah,
that's true. Do you just get rid of it at the end of the day, or?
Yeah, I just delete it. Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise,
man,
your memory would be just. Better than probably buying like one of these other like cameras that.
Yeah. You know, I can use as a phone, you know.
Exactly. Yeah.
I just bought this one for $150. This phone.
Yeah.
The Samsung.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
So just have it for the GPS.
Yeah.
Does Does that one have cellular data then too, or no?
Which one?
The Samsung one.
Yeah, it has a cellular data.
I see.
Yeah, I just take out my SIM from, you know, like when I start working.
Yeah.
Take my SIM out of the iPhone and put it in Samsung, and I use it, and then I just put it back.
Oh, okay, so you're only paying for one line.
Yeah, yeah.
That makes sense.
Like I got stuck in a protest when, you know, like,
oh yeah,
like,
yeah.
The, like last 2-3 months ago, whenever it happened, and there was a lot of craziness going on, so then I decided I should, you know,
yeah, that's true,
do that.
That's true.
Yeah,
my girlfriend works downtown.
Uh-huh.
And when the protests were like just starting and all that happened, initially didn't have to go to work, and then they like changed their mind and they said, oh, everybody should come to work.
Oh.
Well, like a lot of the bridges were closed, and then of course that's the day that she forgot her car keys inside the house and locked it out.
Oh.
And so she had to get a she had to get an Uber, but obviously everybody A doesn't want to start their ride in the middle of a protest.
Yeah.
Or B, everybody's stuck in the
traffic. Yeah, right.
But she was luckily able to get 30-40 Uber back into town.
Okay.
And that was the day that we invested in backup keys.
Okay.
So the protest taught everybody something, right?
Yeah, yeah. He complained to Uber that I'm someone else driving under my name. And then Uber blocked my account. They had to call, yeah, they like, you have to verify that you are driving your own account. So I had to call and I said, I have to keep myself safe.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that was in a very beginning. Like,
yeah,
like
yeah.
A lot of people didn't even have a, you know, knowledge about wearing masks. Or, you know.
Right, what, March then, right?
Yeah, February, March. Yeah, my in the beginning of March, I guess.
Yeah. Dang,
so,
you were ahead of the curve.
Yeah. So, and then I still have a disinfectant spray. I spray, you know. These things, the sides of the door.
For sure.
And on that time, I was wearing gloves, keep the window open.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that was like slow time. You know, like I was just making $50-$60 a day. But I had to do it, you know, like, because I do it full time, so.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, people didn't really have anywhere to go.
Yeah.
Or anybody to be with, so.
Yeah. most of the rides I was getting in the south side. So I was staying in the south side. And when I was not getting any ride, I just keep my key shut down in my car and wait for the ride and using phone or, you know, social media and stuff like that.
I see.
Yeah.
So how many hours would you say you average a day?
Now?
Yeah.
I drive almost 8 to 10 hours a day. I've been driving over like the last 3.5 years.
Yeah.
So now I know most of the vehicle ride.
Even if the directions are telling you something crazy, you
I still can, you know, just see what streets I have to take and that.
That's good.
Yeah.
I can't say the same for myself. It's always a gamble.
Alright. You don't know about
Not enough.
Alright.
I have to like memorize real quick the directions.
Alright.
But I'm getting better.
Okay. Hey, are you from Chicago or you?
I grew up around here, but I didn't grow up in the city. But now, now I live in the city and now I'm more driving down here. Before I used to just take the train from like, the suburbs.
Okay. right here.
Right
here is fine.
I think you should.
Alright. All right. Have a good one, man.
Thanks, bud.
You're welcome. Hi for Lacedro.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Way Kendra.
Right here?
I guess so, yeah.
Alright.
Thank you.
You're welcome, have a good one.
Sure.
Thank you.
Head to your pickup at 451 Watts Huron Street.
Hi, for Jordan.
Yep.
How are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Drop off at
good,
Shaw's Crab
you.
House. make a left turn on North Rush Street. Make a right turn on East Grand Avenue.
Hi, Virginia.
I didn't see the plate on the front.
Yeah, I'm from Indiana, so just every year.
Head to your drop off at O'Neill's on Wells.
How you doing?
Good, good, thank you.
Yo. Thank you. right here.
Yeah.
Have a good one.
Great. Thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you. Have a carry?
Yeah.
Yeah, hi. How you guys doing?
Okay, how are you?
Good. Hungry.
Alright.
And I had a snack and I'm still hungry.
All
even
right.
After the snack.
Alright.
How you doing today?
Good.
Tonight, I should say.
Yeah, good, thank you.
Yeah, them people don't care. When they don't have a don't walk, they don't even care.
Yeah.
No, he had a don't walk. Oh, you know what? Oh, you almost hit a guy, bro. You got drinks in here or what?
Huh?
Where's the cocktails, bro?
Hey, I don't think the Blackstone's open.
It's not, sweetie. And it said it was online.
Yeah. Well, I think it said it wasn't available.
Oh, did it say? That's
where
the one
we
I like.
Go. We'd go to like some dinky
food. That's my favorite one, baby.
There's not really a lot on the street.
I just can't believe that Hilton's closed.
Yeah.
We could have done the Swiss too.
Oh, right. That was on the Swiss too. Yeah, that would have been great.
It probably would have been a little nicer, but for what we were doing,
Yeah.
If we weren't going out for dinner,
yeah,
Swiss next time. For literally enjoying in room, not even fucking leaving, staying in the room the whole time.
That might be
nice.
Yeah.
If we, like, if we stayed at the Ritz tonight, like I wanted to, we would not have left. I would have gotten room service. I would have gotten room service. I would not have left.
Next time.
No. We said that last time. And we keep going to the same place. Can you turn that up a little?
Song?
Yeah. Yeah, please. Thank you. I'm gonna crack a window, my cologne's right, a little strong, buddy. Good, I just put it on. Sorry if I'm bothering your nostrils.
It's okay.
I just put it on. Ooh, look at that G-Wagon. That's hot. That's what you need, babe.
Okay.
Not for the price, though, huh? I seen, the C300, babe. The C300, you can get it starting at 36 grand. That's not bad. Set up for chess, like old school style, where you hit the button. There's that guy.
Probably charge us more.
Well, he was charging us more, babe, because we were a couple. Oh, you want to be a romantic, motherfucker? Yeah, fuck you. $50 for a mile ride.
Right. I feel like it's only me tonight, sir.
That's enough.
Who knows? Can you turn that up a little bit? Yeah, turn that up a little bit. There's the Walgreens.
Oh, right.
You didn't want to walk.
I'm fine. I'm good. I'm all right, John.
All right. You think you'll be all right?
As long as the room's not hot.
I got it down to 65. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Same here. Walgreens is 24 hours here, ain't it, buddy?
Yeah, this one is 24.
It's 24 hours, babe. This is where Bennigan's, remember Bennigan's we were talking about when we watched that show? This is where Bennigan's used to be, right here. Right there, where those people are. Oh, no, wait, I'm sorry. My bad. Where Sweetwater is, right there. Where that place is. That's the old Bennigan. Yeah, we're gonna walk back.
Are we?
We're behind your car.
We're walking back.
Well, we don't have to, like,
right, we'll see. Maybe halfway.
Yeah.
I just want to swing
it. How you been doing Ubering down here?
Yeah, good.
Yeah?
Easy night, yeah.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday, right?
Yeah.
Work 3 days a week.
Yeah, I don't work on Sunday, but Friday, Saturdays are good.
Yeah. You only need to work 3 days a week, probably, ain't it?
Yeah.
Ooh, look at this is the F-type one. This is the one that me and you went and looked at. Remember we went and looked at the blue one? The one that had those tips on the exhaust? The burnt tips, that's the car. That's the regular one. Fucking plate. They bring the steak out to show you. Right here. Yeah, so they bring the steak out to show you. You're good, buddy. You can take a seat.
Alright.
My side, baby. You're good. We'll walk across, brother.
Alright. Have a good night, guys.
You too. God bless.
Thank you.
Stay safe.
Thank you, too.
make a right turn on North Wabash Avenue, then make a right turn on East Wacker Drive.
Yeah, hi.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank
you. I wasn't sure how to like say it on top or below.
Alright. Lower, upper, way.
Giordano's.
Oh, okay.
On,
huh?
Randall's?
Oh, they don't have the... Hey.
Yeah, East Randolph.
East Randolph? Oh, no, I said it tomorrow. You gotta record the whole time?
Yeah.
Just like see you're working or?
Huh?
So they see you know you're working or?
No. It's like for, you know, safety.
Oh, okay.
If an accident happened or some crazy passenger, so I can just flip it.
Go ahead and flip it now.
Be crazy, crazy.
Chinatown is a, you know, Chicago, and Chinatown is a, you know, it's a whole, it's a small town in Chicago.
Okay.
Some people call Chirac, have you heard that?
Chirac?
Yeah.
You been busy today?
Yeah, weekends are busy.
What time do you work till?
I work late on weekends, like till 1 or 2 a.m. in the morning.
Head south on North Bogie Court toward East Randolph Street.